Brenna Fulton and Tracy Martin would like to thank all of the supporters throughout the nation and the world, to everybody that attended a rally, to the millions of people that signed petitions, to the prosecution, Ms. Angela Corey, Mr. Bernie Delarande, Attorney John Guy, and Mr. Rich Manti, and everybody from the prosecutor's office, to everybody that put their hoodies up, and to everybody who said, "I am Trayvon," his family expressed their heartfelt gratitude for helping them these past 17 months. To Tracy and Sabrina, Trayvon's parents, your tireless work in the name of your son has made Sanford and many other cities just a little safer for all our children. I know Trayvon is up there proud at the changes that you as his parents have inspired in his name. This morning, Martin Luther King's daughter, Dr. Bernice King, tweeted me a message that read, "Today is a defining moment for the status of my father's dream." Whatever the Zimmerman verdict is, she tweeted, "In the words of my father, we must conduct ourselves on the higher plane of dignity and discipline." Trayvon Martin will forever remain in the annals of history next to Mega Evers and Emmett Till as symbols for the fight for equal justice for all. Tracy and Sabrina are thankful for all those prayers over the past 17 months since the death of their son. This is a very trying time for their family, and we ask that you respect their privacy. In conclusion, for Trayvon to rest in peace, we must all be peaceful. Thank you.
Thank you. Just a couple of questions. Yes.
Hi. Amanda Evans, News 13. Mr. Crump, the defense gave you a hard time throughout this. They just said moments ago that your first interview with Rachel Gentel was made for TV but not for an investigation. Your thoughts on that?
You know, it's easy to go back in a vacuum. Ms. Gentel, God bless her, she did not want to get involved in this matter in no way possible. And so I think it's pretty well documented about the challenges we had to try to get her to do an interview. And finally, we got her to agree to do a telephone interview, and we did that interview the best we could to make sure that we had her statement. And Trayvon's parents are thankful that she did come forward to act as a witness in this case, something she did not want to do.
What do you say to the citizens of Sanford, people who may not, you know, who like this verdict tonight? I mean, obviously a lot of people are worried about some things happening. What do you say about your city and how exactly they'll receive this news tonight?
What I say is what I told Sabrina and Tracy. I sent them a text and I told them, I said, I listened to the sheriff's press conference yesterday, and he noted all these changes that had been made in the wake of the shooting of Trayvon Martin. And there's a victory in that. There was a child died, and I think that because people took to social media, and because 2.2 million Americans signed a petition on change.org and demanded, not in an effort to persecute George Zimmerman, but in an effort to say that a black 17-year-old child should be able to walk home from the store and not be shot.
Yes.
So I think for the people who did that, I don't want them to be discouraged, because I think they may have saved the life of another child. Because I think that from now on, if there is someone that wants to follow someone with a gun, I think they'll think twice about it. And so for those people, I say thank you for everything. And Sanford is changed for the better. And I think that, you know, there's grace and dignity in what these people did in the peaceful protests.